we have an interesting update here, courtesy of The Guardian, regarding that fabled actually, lauded in some circles and also derided Bottega Veneta party that took place at Berghain, and with the after party taking place at Soho House. People were not happy, right? Not happy in the slightest with seeing Bottega Veneta put on a invite only work party, quote unquote, which is how they got around it, in order to, you know, showcase their presentation. And the after party took place in Soho House, and then allegedly, if you believe the screenshots and some of the messages that are being sent to people anonymously, they've been having, you know, after hours in Soho House for a very long time. It's been kind of a bit of an open secret, which, you know, makes complete sense, that the elites in countries all over the world are basically doing whatever they want to do during a global lockdown, when people aren't able to even go and buy, you know, underwear in shops and stuff. Here they are partying away with no mask on and enjoying themselves. But like I mentioned in my other video, I thought this was something that would just kind of, you know, fly by the night, people forget about it next week. But again, considering how bleak the situation is in Germany, it appears like the Berlin police are investigating it for a breach of COVID rules. So it's courtesy of Guardian. It says the following: Berlin police are investigating a possible breach of social distancing rules at an illegal star-studded party said to have been held at a luxury fashion label, Bottega Veneta. After leaked footage, apparently, of the event inside the private members club in Soho caused outrage in a city whose cherished nightlife has been on hold for ordinary clubbers for over a year. That's true, you know, for over a year you haven't been able to go to a nightclub, because imagine all those videos that we saw in the summer of people going to like Else and whatever it may be, they're all open air parties basically, right? Everything else in terms of being in an actual nightclub was completely gone, shuttered. And this is in a city where, you know, the beating heart of it is nightclubs. So for that entire industry to be completely shuttered, and then to have a, you know, a very luxury fashion house come in, or fashion label come in and put on a party for their select guest, and then kind of do it behind closed doors and, you know, try and get away that way, it's gonna rub you up the wrong way. It continues: a presentation of the Italian fashion label's latest connection at Berlin's famous and exclusive Berghain nightclub last Friday was reportedly attended by a host of celebrity guests, including Nigerian singer Burna Boy. Interesting too, there's not been a lot of outrage towards Berghain, right? Which makes sense. People are probably worried about getting in, and they want to make sure they kind of seek favor with the people involved, because you never know who's watching. But that's interesting though, isn't it? Everyone's got morals, everyone's got ethics, but when it comes to criticizing Berghain for even allowing this event to take place in their building, which, you know, they could argue it's no different than doing the art gallery that they had hosted in there. I'm really sure the technicalities around it, but still, we continue. Grammy Award winner Burna Boy later that evening posted a video on Instagram that apparently showed him dancing behind the turntables inside a crowded restaurant in the 7th floor of the Soho House brunch, which Bottega Veneta had booked for an exclusive use of, used to use 2 weeks prior to the fashion show. Interesting they haven't mentioned Virgil's name on there. I don't know why that is, but he was obviously DJing whilst Burna Boy was dancing. So was this all Burna Boy's fault? Burna Boy got too excited and went to share himself dancing to Virgil playing Fela Kuti or something. Is that why? What caused this whole thing? Burna Boy's inability to put down his phone and just enjoy the party that he's been flown over to enjoy for free. Like, god damn it. He continues: in the video, which was later deleted but as seen by Guardian, none of the party girls are seen wearing a mask. Of course not. A spokesperson for the Berlin police force said, yeah, I received an emergency call at 2:45 a.m. on a Saturday morning complaining about the noise from within the venue, wherever that place is. How did you say that? Would you say that's Tortraza, right? Venue on Tortraza, one of the British group's global network of 31 clubs that open only to members and their guests. So all the Soho houses, the shortest house is open right now. Is that what people are trying to tell me? Madness. It continues: we are currently viewing a footage of the event with a view of possible preliminary proceedings for a breach of measures against coronavirus, spokesperson said. Under the current rules, gatherings between more than 2 people are banned between 9 p.m. and 5 a.m. Hotels are allowed to host business travels but must abide by social distancing rules. Travelers entering Germany from listed of the designated high risk areas, which include the US and the UK. Oh man, it's gonna click it, isn't it? Nope, stop there. Oop, let's go back. And the UK, Bish Bosch. A spokesperson for Soho House Group confirmed that it was looking into a spontaneous party at its venue on Friday and said it was later closed down by the management. The spokesperson said the safety of our staff and guests and wider community is our utmost priority. The recent business booking, which occupied all rooms in Soho House, was made in accordance with the government guidance. Bruv, they booked out every single room in Soho House in Berlin, which, you know, if you've seen it, it's pretty big. It's this here, right? It's like every other, you know, these places that you go around the world, these different group places, but there's a lot of rooms in these places, a lot of rooms, function rooms, meeting rooms. So then to book out the entire thing, they got money, bruv. It continues. We're aware of the possible break of social distancing rules when guests returned to the hotel. We take this very seriously and we're working with everybody involved to find out what happened. Some members of Soho staff questioned whether the party was spontaneous. They said they had already a huge sound system installed before the party. The rumors are going around at the house that Skepta was going to perform, one employee said. Bottega Veneta had not responded for comment. It's interesting too they're not responding, because this has just come after that flipping dog awful article or interview with Daniel Lee, the creative director of Bottega Veneta, where he said the following: social media represents a homogenization of culture. Everyone sees the same stream of content. A huge amount of thought goes into what I do, and social media oversimplifies it. So would you say Daniel Lee is probably anti-vax? I won't say he's anti-vax. It's probably fair to say that Daniel Lee probably doesn't think the virus is a big deal, right? He probably thinks, because he's young and he's virile and he makes cool boots, right, that probably the virus won't affect him too tough. So he's like, you know what, sod it. And then everyone else around him, because he's got the it brand at the moment, they're just going to be what? They're going to be open to just going there because they want to be associated next to the brand. They want a bit of clout and stuff. And you've got all these accounts that are uploading images. Let's see here. This is the account. What's it called? Bottega Veneta. Veneteno, however you pronounce that, it doesn't matter. Oh, Veneteno. Okay, cool. I get it. Well, they're saying a story. They've got some images and videos of people going crazy at the party. You got it? Nothing? Oh, it's like, I'm not loading. It's not going to load. What happened? Did the account get blocked? Oh, it's gone. The account's got shut down. Uh-oh. That account had all the images. You see that? The account's gone now. Okay, cool. That account got shut down. Crazy. Okay, interesting. They shut that account down. Crazy. Bottega coming in clutch, mate. Let's see what they're proud of, update anything. Wow. Okay, cool. Well, that's been shut down by that account. Crazy. So in the end, what will happen? Nothing, probably. Nothing will change. Everyone will go back to regular scheduled programming. Bottega Veneta will come out with a statement. They'll probably donate something to a COVID relief fund or something undisclosed. Daniel Lee will go on pretending like this didn't happen. He'll ignore interviews. And, you know, they'll keep posting on that journal website thing that isn't a blog, that looks like a blog. Because, you know, that's basically where we're at. That's basically where we're at.